Hello students of class 6, welcome to the online tutorial classes for Vidya Bhavan High Secondary School. This video is for life science and the chapter that I will continue today is the digestive system, and this video is part 8. Okay. In the previous video I have shown you the flowchart of the processes of digestive system, but in this video I will discuss the every steps one after another. Okay. So, the digestive organs chemically act upon the food to eat and convert it into the smaller molecules and absorb by your body. So, this procedure is the digestion procedure. So, it is starting from the mouth. The first part is food from the mouth. The first digestion starting in this mouth, and after chewing the food by our tail, and salivary juices are also getting mixed with the food. The food became a softened particle which called bolus. Okay. So after the chewing, while the food is being chewed, it became softened by the saliva secreted by the salivary glands. Salivary gland contains the salivary amylase or ptyalene. So the ptyalene spelling is something different. It is starting with the P. Ptyalene or salivary amylase. Okay, here amylase means that some enzyme that can break down the carbohydrates. Okay, so the only carbohydrate digestion starting from the salivary amylase by the ptyalene. So the starch, the carbohydrate foods or starch are getting digested, or the starches are broken down to the molecules with the help of this salivary amylase. Only the digestion of these carbohydrates are taking place in this mouth. Okay, after this, the softened foods are going to the next part, which is called pharynx. And the food is swallowed into the pharynx and then passes through the esophagus. The pharynx is only the middle part between the mouth and the esophagus, and the muscles of the esophagus push the food downwards to the stomach. No digestion takes place in this part because there is no digestive juices or digestive enzymes present in this pharynx and the esophagus. Okay, so it directly goes to the stomach, the next digestion happening in this stomach. So the next is on stomach. So the stomach contains HCl, hydrochloric acid. So you know it is a very strong acid and it makes the food acidic. Okay, it also works on the carbohydrate type of the food. The muscle of the stomach wall contains rhythmically, like they are functioning rhythm by this rhythm and crushing and grinding the foods properly and mixing with the gastric juice which is present in the stomach. It is called gastric juice. Okay. Gastric juice kills bacteria and helps in the digestion of the protein also. So carbohydrate and protein, both type of digestion are happening in this part of the stomach. So here the pepsin changes the large protein molecules into smaller protein molecules called proteases and peptones. So here proteins with the help of pepsin works on proteins and forms the peptones and proteases. Okay. And the next function is renin. Okay, another enzyme renin which works on casein and produce the paracasein, and it is the insoluble carb. So now only this function only happens in the stomach. After that the food goes to the small intestine, and various type of the juices like the bile juices which is cleaned from this liver, and the pancreatic juices are also mixed in this part. So the further digestion happening in this part, the bile is made in the liver and stored in the gallbladder. In this gallbladder, it is stored for some time, and when the food came, it released from this part. So the next is from the small intestine. Bile helps to digestion and breakdown of the fats into tiny droplets, and for this enzyme and act upon them, they make the fats to become in small granules and they work on them. Okay, the alkaline medium is present in this part. Just remember it properly. Like in the stomach, it is acidic, and after that, in the small intestine, it is alkaline. So the pH are changing. Okay, the acidity and the basicity, these are changing after one after another. Okay, and here there are two or three types of the things, like the protein digestive enzymes are present, fat digestive enzymes are present, also some carbohydrate digestive enzymes are also present. So let me show you the reactions after that. I'm erasing the upper part, rubbing the upper part and writing it on this upper part. Okay. So here, what happens? So here, trypsin present. What is the function of the trypsin? Trypsin act on proteins. It is a proteolytic enzyme and forms the polypeptides. Poly means many, and peptides mean the smaller units of the protein. So that trypsin works on the proteins and made it the polypeptides. Okay, so after this, these are the further broken down of the amino acids to the smaller units, because it is the polypeptide units. From this, the smaller amino acids can be formed. What are the amino acids? Amino acids are the smallest molecules of the protein. So next, the functions of, it is the proteins, it is on the protein. Next, the lipase or fat lysase enzyme, which act on fats and produce lipase, L-Y-P-A-S-E, okay, and produce the fatty acid and glycerol. So the fatty acid also the smaller units of the fat. The next reaction is on the carbohydrates. Okay, the maltase enzyme present in this part, it form maltose, which was forming on this mouth. Okay, maltose, on maltose the maltase enzyme acts and it forming the glucose. Okay, and one more thing I just want to mention here, like the things which are ASE, that means which is present after any of the name, that means enzyme. Here maltase, lipase, this kind of, okay. And other some of the things are present, some of the enzymes are present, like sucrase, which act on sucrose and forming the glucose and fructose. These are the monosaccharides, the single units of the carbohydrate. So the all carbohydrate digestion, like to producing the smallest unit of the carbohydrate, are already done in this part. Next, the lactose digestion is on by this lactase enzyme. See, here also ASE present, here also ASE present, also forming glucose and galactose. Okay, so the small intestine not only digests the food but also absorbs it. The villi in the small intestine contain blood capillaries. Here, the digested food passes through the villi. These blood capillaries enter. By these blood capillaries, it is the foods are digested already, which are the already digested foods and producing the smaller units of the carbohydrate, protein and fat, enters to the bloodstream, and this is called absorption. So what is the absorption? To absorb by the villi, which is present on the small intestine, and there after taking this of the smaller ingredients of this carbohydrate protein fats, these proteins, this function is called the absorption. So, okay, after that, the digestion of the large intestine came. So, some foods cannot be digested and therefore not absorbed in your blood. These foods move down into the large intestine where the excess water has been reabsorbed and the undigested food forms feces, like which move toward the rectum and passes to the regular intervals through this anus. This function is called the egestion. Egestion is the function by which the foods can be go out from our body. Okay, by this I'm completing the full digestion process. After that, I will start the assimilation in the next video. Till then, thank you.